Hey everyone, I'm Professor Stefan. In this video, we are going to continue our beautiful exploration of LIFO with a new LIFO or kind of alternative LIFO method called dollar value LIFO. So let's get started. So what we're going to cover today is kind of what dollar value LIFO is, why some companies choose to use this method, and then build that intuition behind the dollar value LIFO process. Okay. So if you remember from our kind of original class where we started working through cost flow assumptions and we learned about LIFO, everything we've done has been at the unit level, right? Where we see individual transactions for kind of a single product. We build up LIFO layers for a single product. We see prices for a single product. Everything is at that individual product level. Now you can imagine most firms, they sell more than one product, right? And if you sell a whole lot of products, that kind of process of counting and tracking LIFO layers for every individual product could be, you know, time consuming and may not be worth all of the effort that goes into it. So firms in practice are allowed to use this alternative that we're going to call dollar value LIFO. And so this is kind of a shortcut to follow the LIFO process. And it does that by kind of lumping all your products together and tracking your LIFO layers based on dollars instead of individual units. So when we look at the firms that use dollar value LIFO, we see, unsurprisingly, firms that have a huge number of products that they sell. So grocery stores like Kroger, they use dollar value LIFO. You know, in one store, they're gonna have tens of thousands of products, and they don't wanna track LIFO layers and costs and purchases for every single one of those individual products. So they're allowed to simplify here by kind of combining them all together and tracking their LIFO in terms of dollars instead of, you know, individual counts of each product they sell. Similarly with Whole Foods, they use this dollar value retail last in, first out method for most of their inventory. So the way we're going to approach dollar value LIFO is we're going to first measure our inventory using current costs. And so if you think about what a firm has on hand, well, they know the quantities of their goods, the current quantities of their goods, and they know the current prices of their goods. So they're going to calculate the current value of their inventory at current prices. And this is effectively FIFO inventory. Then we're going to take this FIFO inventory and we're going to convert it back to what we call a base year price. And this was kind of taking all the current prices and saying, well, what were those prices back when we started dollar value LIFO? So if we applied all those prices when we started dollar value LIFO to our current inventory quantities, what would the value of our inventory be? So once we have the value of our inventory using the base year prices, kind of so a fixed price, we are going to build back our LIFO layers starting with that first year of adoption. And then we're going to apply kind of the prices from each individual year to those individual layers. So I know looking at this now probably sounds very confusing. The next few slides, we're going to build up the intuition of how this actually gets applied. And we're going to do it for sort of a single product with a single price. And then at the end of this video, we're going to say, okay, when a firm has tens of thousands of products, how does this process that we just saw change? And the nice thing is it only changes just kind of a tiny bit. So if you can understand the next few slides of intuition, you're going to understand kind of the bigger picture dollar value LIFO process. Okay. So imagine on January 1st, 2018, we are starting dollar value LIFO. We have a single product. That product right now costs us $1 per unit and our FIFO inventory value is $100. So kind of at current costs, which is that $1 per unit, our inventory value is $100. And so the question we want to ask is, well, you know, how many units do we have on hand here? And if we know our basic inventory formula where the number of units times the price per unit equals our inventory value, well, we can plug in the numbers we have where we have the unit price of $1 per unit and we have the total value of $100 so that we can kind of back into the number of units, you know, R100. So we'll build our first Lego block here where we have 100 units at $1 per unit for a LIFO inventory value of $100. Now let's fast forward kind of to the end of the year. So we've gone through 12 months of kind of operations and prices of our goods have changed, right? So now at the end of the year, the current cost for one of these units of whatever product it is we sell is $1.05. That's what we have to pay to acquire one of these units that we sell. So the value of our inventory at FIFO prices or at our current costs of $1.05 per unit is $126. So essentially, if we kind of count our units, multiply those units by the current price of 105, that would equal a value of 126. But that's FIFO, and we're trying to kind of convert this over to our LIFO method. And so what we could do is we could say, well, if we know the FIFO value and we know our current unit cost, maybe we can back into what our quantity of inventory is. So if our current units times 105 equals $126, which is what we just said, then we have on hand 120 units. So our number of units of inventory went up by 20. So we kind of build a new LIFO layer here of 20 units at $1.05 per unit. And that means our LIFO inventory value is the 100 units at $1 per unit of that blue Lego block, the big one. And we have 20 units at 105 cents per unit for a total LIFO inventory of $121. So what I want to point out here is that we are kind of starting with current value of inventory using current prices. So the 105 per unit and the $126. And we're using that to convert to a LIFO value of inventory. Now, if we fast forward one more year, we can see that our current cost per unit has gone up to $1.20 per unit. And at these current costs, our FIFO inventory value is $132. And so we can use this to kind of estimate how many units we have on hand. So if we take our unit price times our number of units, that should equal the $132. And from that, we can back into, we have 110 units on hand. Well, if our inventory went down by 10 units, then in under the LIFO method, we lose 10 units out of that, you know, $1.05 block that we built up in the prior year. And our current LIFO inventory value then is the 100 units at $1 a unit and 10 units at 105 per unit for a LIFO inventory value of $110.50. And so what we ended up seeing here is not only did we not build a new layer at this $1.20 per unit, but we ended up liquidating 10 units out of one of our old layers. So going into kind of our final year here, prices have gone up again to $1.25 per unit, and our FIFO inventory value or our current cost inventory value is $168.75. So if we go through this same process to say, well, how many units do I have on hand? How have my units changed in the LIFO kind of setting here? We can see that, you know, the number of units times 125 equals that $168.75. And so we have on hand 135 units total, or an increase of 25 units from the prior year. So we basically built up a new LIFO layer now, this yellow layer of 25 units at $1.25 per unit. So our total LIFO inventory value then is the blue inventory at $1 a unit, the orange inventory of 10 units at $1.05 a unit, and now my new yellow layer of 25 units at $1.25 per unit. So a total LIFO value of $141.75. So we can see that we get a new LIFO layer if our inventory quantities increase compared to the prior year. So the FIFO inventory value increasing does not tell us anything. We have to kind of fix the price and calculate the number of units we have to see how our inventory has changed. Now, if we deplete a layer, if we liquidate a layer, it's gone forever, like those 10 orange units that we liquidated. And if we fail to build a layer, like that green layer during that liquidation year, it's gone forever as well. So they're never going to come back from those prior year prices. We just stacked that yellow Lego block at $1.25 back on top. And so now kind of we've been working with kind of current costs and converting to the number of units we have on hand. And what I want to cover now is sort of how we take that and we aggregate it across multiple products, which is what happens in real life. And so if we have more than one product, we have more than one real price, right? And so what we're going to do is we're going to aggregate or average these products together using their dollar value. And we're going to also average the prices together using a price index. And so we're going to kind of work with dollar values, and we're still going to have what looks like a price, but what it really is kind of an average price change. And so if we applied this to kind of that last year of the example that we saw, we would see, okay, our FIFO inventory value across all the products is $168.75. And our price index, so instead of a unit price, we're going to have a price index, which is just kind of this aggregate price across all our units, kind of how our aggregate prices have changed. Our price index is 125. And that's kind of saying prices have increased 25% since the start of dollar value LIFO. So overall looks the same. We just have kind of slightly different terminology, and these terms mean slightly different things. And so instead of asking kind of how many units we have on hand, we're going to say how much inventory do we have at base year prices? And that's saying if we hold fixed our costs, our prices at that kind of price at the origination of dollar value LIFO, when we started this process, if we hold fixed our prices, how much inventory do we have in dollar values? And so we do the same calculation where we say, okay, if our current value is $168.75 and prices have gone up 25%, so our price index is 125, what would be the value of the inventory if we had fixed our prices when we started dollar value LIFO and the price index would be 1.0, right? That $1 per unit that we saw at the start. So we could see that the value of our inventory at those old prices would be $135. That's equivalent to the 135 units. And so we can see that we add a new layer here that is, you know, worth basically $25. And so all we've done is really change the terminology, but the calculations and the process here is exactly the same. So our LIFO inventory value then takes these layers, which are our values at our base year prices, and multiplies them by each individual year's price index to get us back to a LIFO inventory value. And so what I want to highlight here is that all that has changed is our terminology. We're still working like we're under normal LIFO, sort of like we have one product and one price, but we're just applying different labels to these things because they're really aggregates of products and prices. And so we'll see in kind of an in-depth example in class how this ends up getting applied. Thanks for watching.